For the party, we decided to do mini food and appetizers. Since there are 11 girls, we thought that the prep wouldn't be that much. And so we got these mini paintbrushes with the ridge at the end and stuck the fruit on them. And see, with that ridge, it automatically has a place for the fruit to stay. We used strawberries, pineapples, and red grapes. Then the next thing we made were pretzel rod paintbrushes. And we just used some candy melts, melted that in the microwave, got some pretzel rods, which you can get at any grocery store, Tootsie Rolls, and fruit roll-ups or fruit by the foot. And I got a box that had the red fruit roll-ups in them. So you just unravel it. And then, so the pretzel rod is going to be the wand of the paintbrush. And then I got a steak knife and made 4 cuts into the Tootsie Roll. And that's going to be the brush part of the paintbrush. And you don't have to be, you know, the sizes don't have to be exact. And if it gets spread out too much, just push it in, since the Tootsie Roll is moldable. Then we put a dab of the melted chocolate onto the end and stuck the pretzel onto it. I did put these in the freezer for 5 minutes so that it would harden more quickly. And then I cut off about 2 inches of the fruit roll-ups, which we wrapped around the paintbrush, pretzel rod paintbrush, to cover that part of the chocolate where it was glued together. And since the fruit roll-up also is moldable, you just wrap it around. I had enough fruit roll-ups to wrap it around twice, and then you just push it in so that it will stick on there tightly. And that's your pretzel rod paintbrush. The other prep we're going to show you was the mini veggies in cups. I got these parfait mini glasses from Target about a couple years ago. They were on sale, and so I grabbed that box. And then we have the veggies. We decided to use carrots, celery, and grape tomatoes, and use these colored frilled picks, is what they're called, to put the grape tomatoes on. And so I got ranch dressing. You can also use hummus, you can use spinach artichoke dip, any type of dip that you like, and put it into the glass. And I just tapped it so that it would settle down to the bottom. And then with the toothpicks, I went ahead and put 2 grape tomatoes. That's how many would fit. And if you have smaller tomatoes, you could probably add a third one. And you can decide whether to put them straight up and down across the top of the glass, or even hook it onto the side of the glass, like what I'm showing you here. Okay, so since, again, this is the night before the party when I prepped these mini veggies, you know, you don't want to put them out too early again because of the dressing. So then we just stuck the little carrot sticks, the celery sticks in there, and put the grape tomatoes inside. Isn't that pretty? Okay, so now I'm going to make the prosciutto breadsticks. I got breadsticks from my grocery store, prosciutto, and then cream cheese. So we just open up the breadsticks, and the nice thing about this is I think both kids and adults will enjoy this finger food. I've served this before at a party with, I don't know if I just had some friends over, we just had appetizers, and my daughter liked them too, so I figured, okay, this was a
a little while ago, so I figured, okay, maybe, you know, that age would like something like this. And you can add capers inside if you want, but since I'm going to be serving it to the kids also, I decided not to use capers. Another food idea that I'm going to give you is I did a bruschetta bar or bruschetta. I think you, either way, bruschetta. But I did a bruschetta bar, and one of the things I served was crostini. I toasted the little piece of French bread, put cream cheese, a piece of prosciutto, and then sprinkled some capers on top. See, that was great. Another one was using the same crostini, and then I put fig spread, then the prosciutto. I mean, there's so many ideas for bruschetta. You can find them all over YouTube and Google and different blogs. Okay, so what I do is I just take some cream cheese. Of course, make sure your hands are clean. And then we're just going to put it on. That may be a lot of cream cheese for you, but I love cream cheese. And it's, you know, with the crunch of the bread and, of course, the tastiness of white bread and the saltiness of the prosciutto and the creaminess of the cream cheese. It's really a nice mix. Now, I love it with capers, so I love that the acidity of the capers. Well, see, it sounds like I'm a judge on Top Chef. But anyway, so you take this, you start kind of towards the bottom, a little, not the bottom, but probably because of the size of the breadstick, you know, you just kind of start here, and then you just start rolling it. And that should be enough cream cheese for this particular breadstick. Now you can cover it some more like that, but I think, see, that's enough. See how nice that is? And it's really yummy. And then I'm just going to put it in my container. I got these big Rubbermaid containers with the red cover from Target. They were on sale one time, and so I bought, they have four of them. And they've come in handy because I put the fruit kabobs in there. I'm putting these in there, and I'm preparing this a couple hours before the party. Now, of course, since it's cream cheese, you don't want to put it out too soon. Since the party starts at 3, I'm gonna start putting out the food probably at 2:30. It'll give me 30 minutes. So that means everything needs to be totally in place by 2:30. So the only thing I'm focusing on is bringing out the food, and because of the menu, I'm able to do that. You may have to start sooner, and you know, the last things I'm gonna put are these, the prosciutto with cream cheese, the pears with the goat cheese, and the bango veggies with the ranch dressing. You know, the ones that need to be refrigerated. You put that out at the last minute, as much as possible. Okay, so that's our prosciutto with cream cheese on breadsticks. And both the kids and the adults will be eating this. This is actually going to go onto a food table that's more specifically for the adults, but of course the kids are welcome to it. Okay, thanks. Okay, so now I'm done. There's this much cream cheese left, and I've made 30 prosciutto sticks. And I'm not sure if I mentioned earlier, but if you wanted to put the capers in, you spread the cream cheese, put the capers on top, then you roll it. And so, you know, this is a great idea for the next potluck you're going to, if you get to bring appetizers or ask to bring appetizers. And you can put this, or you can add this to a antipasto tray. You know, the other thing was to use bamboo sticks and put prosciutto with melon, cubes of cantaloupe. And but since we already have the fruit kabobs, I decided to just go with this. I hope you enjoyed that, and hopefully this inspires you to think a little bit outside of the box for appetizers. Okay, thanks. Oh yes, I also wanted to mention that, see, we used almost all of the breadsticks, 2 packets of the prosciutto, so this, and then, you know, you saw how much cream cheese I used up. This costs about $17 with tax, and it took about 20 minutes of my time. So, and it's great because you can prep it a few hours before.